This is the first part of the story. Then second thing is that till now we are clear about two things. We have learned two things here. The first, how I begin was that each one of us are complete, but we cannot experience that completeness until and unless we do something completely. And we cannot do something completely until unless we do something which we really like. And second conclusion was, the second thing which we need to know before choosing any goal is know our dharma type. What is my true nature? That we need to identify first. Then whatever goal I'll choose, that will be the right goal, right? Then to describe the third secret, this we can take as the two secrets for today. To describe the third secret, I would like to take help of a story. I would like to take help of a story, because till now we have discussed two things. Third, I would like to describe in the form of story. Story is a making of a hen. Making of a hen. Hen we need to make. We need to make a hen which has to be almost like a real hen, right? And this task has been given to biological engineers. They are the biological engineers. Let's assume you all are biological engineers. And I am giving you a task that you need to make a real hen. Real hen you need to make. So what is the first thought which comes into my mind? What a real hen should have, right? A real hen which is alive should have basic organs inside, an ability to, it should have ability inside so that this organs can work automatically without any intervention. This hen has to be able to survive and reproduce. This is the basic nature, right? Any human being can survive, he can consume food, he can digest food, he can grow himself, right? And he can also reproduce. These are the basic human capabilities or living being capabilities. So with that, what these people or you have done is, you have added these organs inside to that hen, organs inside to the hen. After that, for first day, let's assume for first day, the hen was working absolutely fine. And you thought that my job was done. I know how to make a hen, real hen. Next day, temperature changed, environment changed. And now, this whatever the organs I have added inside could not correlate themselves or simulate themselves with this outer changes. And that hen is in trouble now. The hen is in trouble now. What to do? What to do? Then, next thing, what we can think? Can anyone think what more we need to add to that hen? Can anyone think about that we have added all the organs, whatever need in the body of the hen, we have added already. And now it requires to simulate its behavior according to the environmental changes. So what else we can add to that hen? Yes, so how we can do that? How to modify that organs? Think, you will get the answer. What else we have that still we have not added to that hen? By experiencing.
Now something has happened. Yeah. Something has happened.
Yeah.
It is quoting that pain and experience.
Mm-hmm.
By quoting that pain and experience, it became evolved completely.
Yeah. So you are very near. How you experience pain? I am talking about the outer things.
How I experience pain means I will have certain gate in my mind.
Again, you are talking about the mind thing, right? I am talking about the, yeah. Okay.
Inbuilt architecture is there.
Okay.
It has programmed like that.
Okay.
By the surroundings or something, it has programmed like that. So, when something is happened, this programming has to change.
Has to change. Yes.
The programming has to change means,
yeah.
It has to experience that, mm-hmm. It has to understand that.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. So what is the thing which we have which really experience and feel the change? I'm only talking about the outer environmental changes which is happening. When I say outer environmental changes, it means temperature got changed, right? For example, that whatever the pressure of air is got changed. It was not raining 1 hour back, now it is raining. this kind of outer changes are happening in the environment, right? This kind of outer changes is happening, and our body is able to, for example, whenever the heat temperature will increase, right, we automatically start sweating happens, right, and our body comes to in the normal temperature. This happen, right? So what is the one thing which really experience? What is the one thing which really experience? Sense organs, right? It is a sense organ. For example, we have some sense organ which immediately, for example, any change will happen, right? For example, immediately if I will close the light, you will automatically understand immediately without seeing that you will understand something has changed. You experience the change. It is our sense organ which helps us to experience the change. So now what the you biological engineers have done is that you have added a sense organ to the hand. Now it has two things now, the organs, the body parts, and now sense organ. It has both now, right? But how, after experiencing thing, how it is going to change inner behavior?
Controlling senses,
okay? We have added body organs, we have added sense organ. What else we have which took decision?
Consciousness.
Sense organ, what it does is, it simply take input from the outside environment. It passes through the nerve system. We can say a mind or brain, whatever it is, right? You can say a brain. It passes this inputs, outer experience to this particular nerve system, and which takes the decision and instructs the muscles to take this action, to take some action, right? So this nerve system which I am talking about, you can assume like, as you are saying, we can assume like a program. You can assume like a program. We can feed this particular hand with a program. In this program, what we have added is thousands of conditions. If this change will happen, take the action A. If this change will happen, take action B. For example, if I'm showing a fire, you should run. This kind of basic instincts, right, which we have. So such kind of program they have written. And they have put it inside the hand. So now this hand is what is able to do? It is able to survive, reproduce, right? Sense that outer environmental changes, and also it is able to take its own action. So now it is very much capable and very near to a hand. So how many of you think that we have achieved our target 100%? This hand is able to do everything what a real hand can do. So how many of you think that this hand is very much capable and complete in itself? 100% I'm talking about, not even 99%. 100% full, complete. It's not complete. What is missing there?
Control. See, some heat has came to me. I'm controlling that. I'm coping that heat, but I'm not able to do what I want to do instead of things going around me. Now, heat is going around there. So when it is say complete means that has to think what has to happen.
Okay.
I have to do what I have to do.
Okay.
So that is this.
Okay. Any other answer? You're very close. You're almost right. Any other answer someone have? Because I want you to think. Because when we think right, something happen inside. He's saying that it is controlled. It is controlled. And why I said,
it is yeah. But it is not involving other things.
Yeah, involving other things.
Let us consider I'm going in the traffic.
Yeah.
So some sounds are there, some beeps are there, some pollution is there. What it is doing is, it is creating a mess in my mind and mess in my body.
Yeah.
But what is thing is happening is, I have to experience some other thing.
Yeah.
See, I should have to work on that So that means I have to lose the control of my senses.
Okay. So how I see this hen is, which we thought that it is complete, our job is done. Let's assume we have written 1,000 conditions. 1,000 condition we have written. And to kill that hen, I need to think about one condition which is other than this 1,000. 1,001 condition. One additional condition, I can kill that hen. That hen will fail to respond. That hen will fail to respond. And that is the one thing which I found. That is the one thing which really makes the difference between a machine and a human being, a living being, you can say. And what is that thing? What is that thing is, it is the desire to live and desire to grow. Our basic instincts. What is our basic desire? What is the most precious desire anyone have is, first, everyone want to live. No one want to die. No one want to die. Even though they are in a deathbed, they don't want to die. They want to live at least a day more. That is the kind of desire everyone want to live. And second thing, if someone is living, they want to grow themselves. Any aspect it can be. Someone want to grow in money, someone want to grow in intellect, someone want to grow in spiritually, right? There are various aspects. But everyone want to do something better for themselves. That is the human nature, right? That is a living being nature. Every living being want to do this. So the desire to live and desire to grow, this is one thing which is still missing in that hen. And that we, at least in my knowledge, right, we cannot feed so easily in some machine. The desire to live and desire to grow, that we cannot feed. And the desire is the most important thing which makes someone successful, and desire are the same thing which makes someone very unsuccessful in their life. The desire. We have in our written text, we have so many examples, especially in the religious texts and so many other texts, that they say that desire itself is bad. Desiring more is bad. If you desire more, you cannot have a peace in your life. Desire is bad, right? But when I was again thinking about this thing, really desire is bad, but do I know what is desire? What is the nature of the desire? What happened when I desire something? What happened really inside when I desire something, right? And then I started searching, what is the desire? When I was searching this, where I reached? The desire is nothing but energy. Desire is energy. And to understand the desire, we need to understand the energy. What is the nature of energy? What is the basic nature of energy? Yeah. The energy of nature is that whenever, and I am talking about your energy, when I say energy, it is not some outer energy, I am talking about the inner energy, what we have, what we possess inside. So our nature of the energy is, when we pass this energy to something, we want energy in a response. When we pass energy in the form of desire to something, we want something in response. We always want some response out of our every act. That is the nature of desire and energy, right? And to understand this very easily, let's assume that in your family, you have some younger brother or younger sister. You care a lot about them. It might be your children, someone. You care a lot about them. You love them too much. But you are continuously giving your good caring, love, everything of yours, you're giving to them. And they don't give any response to you. How you feel. You will do this for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. You are doing continuously and you don't get any response. So what is and what will be your experience is, every time you will do something good for them, you will be ready to get some response. You will feel inside that I have lost something. I have wasted my energy. This kind of feeling we get. We do something for someone else and we don't get anything in response. We feel that we are lost. We have lost something. And just try to switch this desiring or this particular flow of energy to your delicious food. What I said in the beginning is that when I give my energy in the form of desire to something, if I get my desire output, I feel more energized inside. It means if I'm giving energy, I'm getting response energy. response energy. So I'm feeling happy inside. I'm feeling more energized. I'm doing, willing to do more, right? But on the other hand, if I have some delicious food, let's have, this paradise biryani I have, right? I had it enough. After that, what will happen is, to consume that food inside, I need to give some energy. Even though to eat that food, right, I need to spend some energy. And to consume it, I need to some energy. But what is the nature of this food is, my delicious food is, after digestion, it is going to produce energy. So, when I'm giving energy to something, and I'm getting energy in the response, right, getting energy in the response, I feel good. This is the nature of desire and energy. And what we can conclude this is, that desires are bad. Desires are bad when we only give our energy to my desire thing and give more and more energy to it. You keep on giving, And when I'm saying keep on giving, you are simply thinking about your desire. This I have to get. You are thinking all the time. We feel very fashionable that we are dreamer. We are dreamer. And I have seen so many dreamer who are nowhere in this world. It means they are in the world, but they are not in the world. They are continuously thinking. They are continuously thinking and losing their energy. They are losing, right? So this happened with the dreamers. And what is the trick? What is the best way to deal with the desire? Again, because when I get obstacle in front of me, I don't stop thinking. I try to, because every problem I believe, there is a root cause. There is a card and there is a root cause. There is a cause means which appears as a cause. For example, some problem will happen with me, right? I'll simply say cause, because of this, it is happening. But if when I try to think more, there will be another cause, hidden cause. I am always concerned about root cause, because root cause can only help us to solve problem, not to solve the problem, but to solve the problem in a little deeper level, and which is more sustainable, right? So when I was saying the desires are bad, how desires are bad, I would like to take up a word of Swami Vivekananda. What he said about the work is, pay attention to the means as to the goals. The biggest problem with the goals is that the big goals are enchanting so much inside that we almost forget what exactly we need to achieve to achieve that goal. We forget. We are thinking about the goal day and night. But we don't know how to achieve that goal. We are not thinking about the silly things we need to do every day in our life to achieve that goal. And when this happened with anyone, and that is the only thing I have found till now which really differentiate a thinker and a doer. And when I do not want to stop myself as a doer, I want to say achiever. That is the one thing which makes the difference, a thinker and achiever, right? And what is the trick here is to deal with the desire is, if you can stop writing and listen this for a moment, right? How this achiever deal with the desire is, everyone as a human being have the similar kind of desire. But what this achiever do is, and what I do is, that whenever this desire go up inside me, I cannot live without that thing which that happens inside me. Immediately I shift my focus, what exactly I need to do at this moment, not after 5 years, not after 2 years, what exactly I need to do and what I can do right now to achieve to that goal. So I shift that flowing energy, which is flowing towards the desire by default, I shift that to my task, and I put entire energy to the task. What will happen is, if I do something right, whether I fail or pass, and when I say fail or pass, it only means whether I get immediate response output immediately or not, right? It is the experience of doing. When a young person feel happy, when we feel happy is when we feel something, we were desiring something to do and we have done it. It is the experience and the joy of doing, right? So what I can do is that whenever something come as a long-term goal inside my mind, I should see myself where I am, what I can do right now. And somehow it is very difficult sometimes. It is very difficult to shift that energy to that immediate task. Because again, that immediate task, your nature is, our nature is, we see immediate response from the immediate task. How our mind play with us is that your goal is, let's assume you want to earn 10 million in your life, very simple example. And you have to, what you need to do is, you need to wake up at 5 o'clock today morning. What is the goal? Earning 10 million. What is the activity you need to see? Waking up 5 o'clock. And your mind will say, man, 10 million. What you will do with this five, waking up at 5 o'clock? Leave it. Think about your bigger goal. Think about the bigger goal. And that's how we have produced so many thinkers. I see around, when I think about this, when I see today, this public speaking, right? In past 10 years, I can see, there are so many speakers around. And everyone is speaking. Everyone have books. And I'm also not. I'm also one of them. But I don't speak about a book until I do some things with that book. Right? And I've seen so many things. I'm not criticizing anyone. But I'm simply saying that why we are producing so many thinkers and so many individuals who are able to talk hours and hours, but there is no outcome of their talk. Why so much talk is happening around and there is nothing changing in my nation? Why there is nothing happening? And one thing I know about this speaking is, or any activity which we do, we cannot, it is very important, we cannot, we cannot give someone what we are doing or what we are speaking. We can give someone only what we are. If I'm a liar inside my heart, if I'm saying so many great things in front of you, what you will feel is, you will immediately know this person is lying. Even though he is talking about the ultimate truth, but this individual is lying. So it is about being, it is about experimenting with the self, and honestly doing justification with the self each and every moment. Lot of people say, this I have seen, the lot of people say, they meet, that these are the family problems are going on in me. These are the, some problems are going on me in financial things, some problem are going on. Once this will get settled, once my family condition will be good, once my financial condition will be a little stable, I'll start working for my dream. And what is the biggest beauty of these problems is, problem don't get resolved in a day, and they have the very specific reproduction nature. You wait for one problem to get it resolved. Once this problem is, you think that this problem is resolved, you get another problem. You shift your focus from one problem to another problem, and then another problem. And one time, in one age, we reach to a state and we say, why I have not achieved something in my life? Because I had so many problems in my life. This is the conclusion of many. But again, I say that can we find out any great individual in the history who has no problem in their life? The bigger character you will look for, he has the bigger problem. These are the problems which has made this individual so big in the world. The bigger problem they have chosen in their life, the bigger they have become. And we are waiting simply for the silly problems. How to judge a person is living great life and an ordinary life, in my understanding, is what kind of problem he's thinking about right now. Very simple. What kind of problem he's thinking, he is concerned about that particular thing. And that is his thinking. And he will live around that thinking, and he will never reach somewhere else. It means big individuals, right? Like prime minister, this president, all these things, they think about the big things. Their problems are big. We see ourselves as not as great. Why? Because our problems are also very simple. And we're taking help of those problems. Someone asked me a few years back, you should have patience. Because I was trying to run so hard, right, for my passion. Someone asked me, you should have patience. And these kind of conclusions they give to us out of their own experience. If you want to achieve something big, you should have extraordinary amount of patience in your life. But what is the definition of patience for me? Why I want to have patience? I just want to have patience just because I do not want to start today one more day. I want to take rest. I do not want to start, and that's why I'm keeping patience inside. I do not want to start, and I'm saying that I'm patient. I want to, because I have big goal, man. I am going to achieve that after 5 years, after 10 years. I should have patience. It will come. The day will come when I'll become superstar. When I say this word, right, superstar, everyone somewhere in the corner of the heart, everyone want to become superstar. But nobody is, it is very common saying nowadays that nobody want to pay what it takes to become a superstar, right? But forget about the superstar also. It is about this patience. So whether I want to have patience just want because I do not want to start today working, or I want to have patience inside because I am so impatient inside. I'm so impatient inside that I cannot control myself. I want my goal, my dream to make it real today itself. I'm so uncontrolled inside, and now I want to have patience so that I can flow my energy in some controlled way, and so that I can execute my today's tasks in a controlled way, some way. To control my impatient state, I want to have patience. See the difference. See the difference. I say that one time, one should focus on one thing. But on the other hand, one cannot learn how to focus on one thing until unless he is surrounded with the many things. One should have patience. But no one can experience the patience inside until he is so impatient inside. It is the complete reverse effect, right? Complete reverse effect. So we have so many in the world, I'm talking about the world now, we have so many great individuals around who have given great and great conclusions. They have written so many great literatures, and we are by-hearting them day by day. We are by-hearting them day by day. But, and I'm not denying that those conclusions have something missing in them. But it is not about the conclusion. It is about our experience. When I am accepting those conclusions, after experiencing that or after listening that, after reading that, right? I read the human being is complete. I listened that in the seminar. Story over. I am complete. What I need to do? Someone can take in that direction also, right? But I am only concerned about the experiencing. Any success if I talk about, it is not... Any success journey, if I talk about any journey, is not at all about what I am going to achieve. It is only about how I am experiencing my life. What is my experience of life? How I experience today? Am I joyful inside? Am I happy inside or not? Right? That is, those are the things we need to think about our life, about taking any conclusion in the final conclusion. Right? So if we do that, right? If we do that, so definitely, there would be a better possibility to create something. And why I'm again and again using this word, that do something big, do something big. Because I'm really concerned about what I have started with. This many people, five type. We don't know what is our type exactly, right? We could be the medium of helping hand for those people who don't have their own capability inside. And it is very needed. It is very much needed. And to summarize this entire discussion which we are talking for so long. So how I can summarize is today's discussion is that what we need to exactly do, what we can do. That first thing we can do is know your type. Then once you are clear about your type, try to know what is your goal. First know your type. Then try to know your goal. Then try to work upon those goals in an unattached way. Once you are clear, right, this is what I am, this is my true nature is, and this is what I have decided to do, then I need to do unconditionally, unattached way. I need to do it. And when something I'll do for the long, long time like this, and if I'm saying long time, don't think about 1 year, 2 year, 5 years, right? It could be a 3 months, it could be a 6 months based upon your intensity. It is not about the duration, it is all about the intensity, right? How much energy we are putting, right? So once I am very clear with my type, my goal, then I will practice to do it in an unattached way. Then what will happen is, if you start living in that zone, something will grow inside you. some art will produce inside you, some talent will produce. You will see your possibilities. You will see your possibilities. And when you see your possibilities, something will grow inside you, right? You will grow. Whatever you will create, whatever you will touch, it will become gold. That is the power of this understanding and this conclusion, right? So this is what I was willing to share as a part of the lecture. This is what I was willing to share as a part of lecture. This is the today's conclusion we can take. These are the few points we can think about. Whether it is right or wrong, that you need to decide, right? It is right or wrong, you need to decide. But at least we can start thinking in that direction as well. Because we are thinking about so many other things which are now nowhere related to us. Why not to think about myself? I am very much concerned about myself, right? So when you start thinking in another direction, definitely I would learn something new in a month or two. Because thinking has some its own reaction inside. It change you, right? So this is the